Hello ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Exotic Astrology again, and many of you had requested me for the analysis of the Navamsha chart using Ashtak Varga. So how to see from D1 to D9 and the different areas of the chart using Ashtak Varga only. Alright, so today we'll try to see some of these areas. And as usual, if you are new to the channel, please subscribe to it. And if you want a consultation from me regarding your Ashtak Varga, please go to my website down in the description section. And yes, God is there with you all the time. Just look to him and you will find him. So this chart I have shown in my channel many times. And if you go to the Ashtak Varga chart again, just as a reminder, this number one which you see is Aries, okay? This is not referring to the first house. So you see one is Aries. So for Scorpio, Aries is the sixth house. Okay. And there he has these points summing up to 32 points. All right. So now let us try to see the chart first, and then we will see the Ashtak Varga, and then we go to the Navamsha, because many times people, they think that why am I discussing about the chart and the Ashtak Varga, or why am I not directly going to the topic? But the problem is, if you keep dancing like this to the topic directly, you will not understand. You will be totally headless and confused about what to do, and then you will be seeing 10 videos and still understand nothing. All right. So if I am spending time initially in explaining something, it is essential that you understand. Otherwise, even I do not like to waste my time. All right. So now let us go to the chart. You see this, I would like to explain about his career and finances, okay? So if you see his 10th house where Leo is, so number 5, if you go and check here, you see Sun, Moon and Mercury and Jupiter has highest contributions, okay? So now Mercury and Jupiter, when they are together and associated with the 10th house, can show finance sector, okay? But that is not enough. It can show spirituality also, or becoming a monk or a sannyasi. It can show so many things. How do you know it is the finance sector only? You have to check the lordship. So if you check in this chart, Jupiter is lord of the 2nd house. His Mool Trikon sign Sagittarius is in the 2nd house. That is why 2nd house is the house of finances. So when Jupiter contributes to the 10th house, as the 2nd lord, he will show finances. And as the 5th lord, it can show giving guidance to others. Okay, so consulting is seen here, because Mercury is the Karaka for consulting, and Jupiter also to some extent. And they are having the highest contributions, if you see here, 5 points both of them. And because Sun and Moon also have 4 contributions, so therefore it is essential that this is linked to the government sector. Okay, this may not show private sector necessarily, because Sun and Moon are planets that represent the government. So this person could be interested, or I would say this person is interested to work in the government and also in sectors related to the finance. Okay, and apart from that, if you check what is going on in his ascendant. Just check his ascendant. In fact, this is the first thing I should have done. I just missed it. So you see Scorpio is rising. So number 8 is here. Okay, 27 points. This. So you see Moon has the highest contribution there. Moon is the 9th lord. Then Jupiter also has quite contribution. And Venus also. So Moon as the 9th lord contributing quite a bit to the Lagna is very good, and Moon is also placed there in debility, of course. So now if you try to see this in the Navamsha, you will see, so externally see what is happening. The Lagna chart tells you what is going on. So he has 9th lord contributing highest to the Lagna. Alright, so this is something which I had shown when I did the chart for analyzing Vimshottari Dasha also. That in that chart also, that was a Libra ascendance chart, and he was interested in animal protection, and his 9th lord Mercury was contributing 7 points. So here also, I mean to his ascendant, which is Libra, to here, to Scorpio, his 9th lord Moon is also contributing 6 points, which is fantastic. And this chart is of one of my god brothers. He's my great friend, and he's very elevated spiritually and very much committed to his spiritual practices. So this is it's very obvious that the ninth lord, which shows spirituality, is contributing, and therefore the results will manifest. Do you see how powerful Ashtakvarga is? Well, but let us go and check what is going on in the Navamsha chart. So in the Navamsha, if you want to see spirituality, you have to see first of all the situation of the ninth lord of the Lagna chart in the Navamsha. Should I repeat? The situation of the ninth lord of the Navamsha, of the Lagna chart in the Navamsha, okay? And after that you check the ninth lord of the Navamsha. So first you see what is going on here. The ninth lord of the Lagna chart is Moon. It is in Lagna in both the Rashi and the Navamsha. This is known as Bhavottam. And this means that the planet Bhavottam means it is in the same house in both the Rashi and the Navamsha, and Vargottama means it is in the same sign in the Rashi and in the Navamsha. Okay, so when a planet is Bhavottam, what it can show is that the house where the Bhavottama is occurring, which means the house where both of them are placed in the same house, which means the first house here, is extremely strong, and the planet will be able to fully implement itself through the power of that house. So here you see Moon, as I said, is the ninth lord. So this shows connection with your guru and spirituality. This is an extremely powerful placement. Okay, so this shows that now Lagna is the self. So whenever any planet is in Lagna, those people come to you. You don't have to go to them. So ninth lord in the Lagna can show the guru comes to you. Lagna lord in the ninth can show you are running towards your guru. Okay, now he is very interesting. What is he doing? You see, Venus is his Atmakaraka. Atmakaraka is in the ninth house. That means from many lifetimes he is seeking God and gurus and spirituality, and in this life the guru is walking towards him. Oh my God, what a wonderful thing this is, because the Lagna shows what you are doing in this life. Okay, and this is wonderful combination to have. And then I told you, check the ninth lord of the Navamsha chart. Okay, so here you see Venus is the Lagna lord of the ninth lord of the Navamsha chart, and he is exalted here in the seventh house. This is a fantastic placement to have. The Atmakaraka in exaltation in the Navamsha, or associated with the ninth house, or Jupiter or Moon, these are best combinations for spiritual progress. And therefore, it is highly essential that we try to understand what is the base of the chart. And therefore, using Ashtakvarga also, we can confirm what is going on here. Okay. And now if you check the now we have checked for the ninth lord. Okay, now similarly we have to check for the 10th lord also. Okay, so 10th lord is Sun. He is placed there in Digbala. Now you see what is happening here in Lagna chart. Sun is in Digbala, but here in the Navamsha chart Sun is in Dikshunya. Okay, so this can show that externally the person is working towards doing big things in life, but internally he may feel that it is best if I could stay in my home and not show myself too much to others. Okay, which is very true. He's not a person who likes to expose his achievements or show too much to others. And therefore now you have to see what is going on in the Ashtakvarga. You see 10th lord is Sun. He is placed there. So now you check which are the points the 10th lord is contributing. Okay, so the 10th lord is contributing 7 points to the 6th house, which is Aries, because Aries number 1 is 6th house here. Okay, then 3 points, then 5 points, then the points are almost average. And if you see in third house, which is Capricorn, 10th lord is contributing quite a bit, and the 10th lord is also contributing to the 11th house, which is Virgo, which is fantastic for finances. Okay, So that means the planets Mars and Mercury and Saturn, these three planets will hold a very important say whenever it comes to his finances, because the 10th Lord is saying, I am interested in these areas, which means I will try to show my influence through these houses, through these planets. Okay, so I'm repeating, Mars, then it is Mercury, and then Saturn. So now you check these three planets in the Navamsha chart. Okay, I repeat, check these three planets in the Navamsha chart. So now you see the magic. You see Saturn is placed there in the 7th house. It is in Digbala. It is with the Atmakaraka Venus. This shows fabulous wealth. And Atmakaraka Venus aspecting the Lagna can show that the person has been born in a very good family. And if you see the other planet Mars, it is also in the 9th house, which is also fabulous. And it is with Jupiter, which is even better. And the other planet Mercury is in the 11th house of gains, network circles and finances. Okay, so externally the Ashtavakra can say that I will give him money from these sources, but will he able to earn money finally? Will he be able to do it at the end? That you have to check from the Navamsha. And if you see, Mercury is again in the sign of moon. It again shows government related things. Okay, and Mars is in the sign of Venus. This can show big multinational corporations. And Saturn is in the sign of Jupiter. This can also show some big consulting firms, okay, like BCG or McKinsey or any of these consulting firms. And therefore, even here, if you see, the 11th Lord is in the Lagna. It is fabulous for finances. Moon is in the Lagna, and here the Lagna Lord is in the 11th house, okay. So overall, this is a very powerful chart for finances, extremely powerful. And these three planets, Mars, Mercury and Saturn, these three are extremely well placed in the Navamsha. One is in Digbala, one is in the 9th, and another one is in the 11th house. So therefore, his monetary gains is assured. It's like Lord Narayana has assured him that he will be successful in these regards. And what to speak of his Atmakaraka. Atmakaraka is in the 9th house. Here it is an exaltation. Fantastic chart. Alright. So we can discuss more on the Navamsha chart. And try to see what is going on where. Okay. And also the one thing I forgot to mention was the Lagna Lord and 11th Lord are in Parivartan here. You see Moon and Mercury are in Parivartan. This can show worship related to Lord Krishna, which he is very much interested in. And because Venus is aspecting, therefore he is a big worshipper of Radha and Lakshmi, and you can also see Moon is in Anuradha in the Lagna chart, which can also show worship related to Radha and Krishna. Alright, so these are some small clues which I have given in between, and this is how you analyze the Navamsha chart and link it with the Lagna chart and try to use the power of Ashtavakra to know which things can give you wealth and fortune in life. Alright, thank you so much. If you are new to the channel, please subscribe to it. And if you want a consultation regarding your Ashtavakra only, then you can go to my website for a special Ashtavakra reading. And if you are new, then subscribe. And if you like this video, click the thumbs up and share it with somebody who is also interested to know about Navamsha and Ashtavakra. And yes, God is there with you all the time. Just look to him and you will find him.